In last class, we have studied about parallel plate capacitor in which both plate carries equal and opposite charge. But right now, we have studied about parallel plate capacitor in which both plates carry unequal charge. Because in last class, we know that parallel plate capacitor having capacitance C is equal to epsilon naught A by D. We will see what happens if both of the plates carry unequal charge. So, capacitance of a parallel plate capacitor in which both of the plates carry unequal charges. So there is a two plate. Suppose this one is plate one and this one is plate two, that is second plate. If plate one carry Q1 charge and second plate 2 that carry Q2 charge. So what happens? Because we have to find the capacitance using these two parallel plates. So you have to distribute the charge in the left and the right passes accordingly. So you suppose that the area of the plate B A. So if the area of plate B A, and you just suppose the separation between the plates B D. So you have to distribute this Q1 in this space and in this space. Accordingly, you have to distribute Q2 in left of the face and right of the face. You just remember one thing, that the thickness of both of the face, the thickness of both of the plates be negligible. So you just think that thickness of the plate be negligible. That means this Q charge is reflected on both of the faces. So for plate 1, due to this charge Q1, electric field lines will be in this direction. If it is positive, and for this charge Q2, field lines will be in this direction if it is positive. So accordingly, we have to distribute both of the charges on both of the faces of a plate. So we will discuss for the plate 1. This one is your plate 1. You just give a name. Left is just it is said to be A, right side it is said to be B, again left side is said to be C, and again right side is said to be D. So I want to find QA. This QA is how much? So simply this QA will be you have to think this one just like by field lines. So suppose this one is Q1 will be the charge, this one is positive charge. So what happens, this Q1 charge will be reflected on both of the faces of this plate. So field lines will be in right of the direction as well as in left of the direction also, in this direction. Accordingly, for face A, this face A that is getting charge Q1, but what happens, this Q1 is just Q1 by 2. Why? Because you have one charge that distributed on two faces. So out of two, you are going to negate on one face. So you have to take charge as a Q1 by 2. Similarly, Q2 is also, by Q2, your electric field lines is also coming in this phase A. So this Q2 is also distributed on both of the faces of this plate, out of which you are going to be considered along one direction. So your charge will be in one direction out of the two faces, like this. Like this. So you have to take also at phase A Q2 by 2. That means you are getting in this direction how much be the total charge Q1 by 2 and Q2 by 2. But because this Q1 is reflecting in this direction, you want to take this one in this direction. Similarly, Q2 is in this direction. So what happening? Q1 along left direction. And for this phase, Q2 is also along left direction. So altogether, at a place A, you are getting Q1 and Q2 both along left direction. Therefore, Q1 by 2 plus Q2 by 2 resultant will be Q1 plus Q2 by 2. Therefore, your QA that will be Q1 plus Q2 by 2. So you got this QA. Now you have to find charge at place B. Exactly what happening here? The direction due to charge Q1, the direction of field lines is along left to right. But the field lines in the direction due to this charge Q2 from right to left. So it will be considered as positive. Similarly, Q2 will be considered as positive, negative. But we have to take the same concept, that this one is Q1 by 2 and this one is Q2 by 2. Okay, then your QB that will be, if Q1 is taken as positive, why? Because this one is along left to right, because you have to find at B. So B will be positive for this case. Therefore, Q1 minus, this one is along opposite to the direction of the field lens due to the charge Q1, that's why due to charge Q2 it would be taken in opposite direction, that is negative. So Q2 divided by 2. Second equation. Now you want to find at phase C. So there is QC. So at phase C, what you are getting for this section? This one is along this direction and this one is along this direction. But you have to find the charge at phase C. So you have to take C as positive. So for this section, you are taking C positive from right to left. But this one is from left to right. So Q2 by 2 will be positive and Q1 by 2 will be negative for this phase. So that would be Q2 minus Q1 by 2. Next equation. Third. Again, if you wanted to find the charge at this section D, so how much that would be at phase D, what happening? See, Q2, if Q2, it would be taken in this direction from left to right. So Q2 will be positive, and now the field has that coming from Q1, which it is also along this direction. That means Q1 and P2 by electric field lines, it is taken as in same direction. Therefore, Q1 by 2 and Q2 by 2 both are positive. Therefore, your QD will be Q1 plus Q2 by 2. Equation 4. So what you see, now you first compare this QA and this QD. Your QA and QD will be equal. Why? Because this one is Q1 plus Q2 by 2 and this one is also Q1 plus Q2 by 2. That's why simply you can see from equation 1st and 4 that your QA is equal to QD. Also from equation 2nd and 3rd. From these two equations, 2nd and 3rd, you can see that both are equal and opposite. How's that? If you will take negative sign from here, it would be Q1 minus Q2 by 2, like equation 2. That QB is equal to Q1 minus Q2 by 2. Therefore, from equation 2 and 3, both charges are equal in magnitude, but opposite. Therefore, QB is equal to minus QC. So this is the way of distribution of charge if the charges Q1 and Q2 carry unequal on both of the parallel plates. So simply you just write down here. Now charge at this phase is Q1 minus Q2 by 2, Q1 plus Q2 by 2, because according to field lines both are in same direction, and here this one is Q1 minus Q2 by 2, because by this charge it is coming from left to right, from this charge the field lines is coming from right to left. Now, on this section, on this face of this plate, this one is Q2 minus Q1 by 2, and here is again your Q1 plus Q2 by 2. So this is the way. So wherever you want, but here right now I want to find the capacitance of this due to this parallel plate. So to find capacitance, right now here you have to find the field lines between these two plates. You just remember So electric field produce electric field in between parallel plates. Electric field between the parallel plate to pass each other is E1 plus E2. You can write down either E1 plus E2 directly, otherwise E1 minus E2, because E2 is in opposite direction. Then there, what happens, whenever you will put the value sigma by 2 epsilon 1, so at there you have to consider sigma, that will be negative. Otherwise you can directly write down E is equal to E1 plus E2, it is directly. Therefore, if wanted to put this one directly, so no issue, E is equal to E1. So your E1, that would be sigma by 2 epsilon naught. Why this one is sigma by 2 epsilon naught? Because your charge Q1, that is distributed on right and left faces of this plate. So this one is Q1 minus Q2 by 2. This one charge that reflecting on both of the faces as a electric field lines, and out of that, out of two electric field lines, you are going to consider at one face. So who is responsible? Your charge. That's why you have to take in here sigma by 2 epsilon naught plus again for E2 sigma by 2 epsilon naught. So finally resultant will be sigma by epsilon naught. Now put the value of sigma. So your sigma is surface charge density, and surface charge density you have to put Q minus Q2 by 2. Why? Because this one and this one both are equal but opposite in nature. That's why we just stick here Q1 minus Q2 by 2. This one is your charge into A, area of this plate, into epsilon naught. So this one is your finally, this one Q1 minus Q2 divided by 2A epsilon naught. This is your electric field. Now again you have to find the capacitance between the plates, you have to calculate the potential between the plates. Therefore the electric potential, the electric potential between the parallel plates, your electric potential, there is a relation between electric field and potential. You must say this one is equation 5. So there is a relation in between potential and electric field. This one is V is equal to ED. V be the distance between the two parallel plates. Therefore V is equal to ED. Now put the value of E from this equation 5. And this one is Q1 minus Q2. Q1 minus Q2 divided by 2A epsilon naught into dB there. This one is equation 6, and you got your potential between the two parallel plates. Right now you have to find the capacitance. Therefore capacitance C will be C is equal to Q by V. Q is your charge on either of the plate. So you have to take the charge on either of the plate, because your Q be same on both of the plate but only opposite in nature. So either of the charge you can take, you don't have to take negative signs accordingly. Therefore just put the value. So your Q is Q1 minus Q2 divided by 2. This one is your charge and then put the value of V from this equation C. So again this one is Q1 minus Q2 divided by 2A epsilon naught into D. From here you are seeing that Q1 minus Q2 in numerator and denominator, so both will be cancelled. So finally your capacitance, now here is 2 and here is also 2, so 2 will be also cancelled, so denomination of denominator will be taken as numerator, therefore epsilon naught A by D. So your resultant is epsilon naught A by D. So this resultant shows that equation 7 is there. So this equation shows that there is no effect of charge on capacitance of any parallel plate capacitor, whether it is distributed by equal charge or unequal charge, because for parallel plate capacitor your capacitance will be only depends on its configuration, and your configuration is directly proportional to surface area of the plate and inversely proportional to the distance between them. Therefore here we are getting the same result epsilon naught A by D as a result.